Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Pokemon Y. This is episode 9, and my name is Josh Jepson. But you knew that already. This is the last single-digit episode, guys. This is a big deal. It's really not. But anyway, in the previous episode, we destroyed Snorlax. I kind of meant to catch it, but I destroyed it instead. And we continue on past this bridge. But first, I'm going to go back and head this way, because we didn't go this way last time. But before I do that, I want to go over a couple things that I did off-screen. If we go to my Pokemon here, we have leveled up a bunch of our Pokemon here. Well, I mean, a bunch of our Pokemon. We only have three. But I was meaning to get Franklin here to level 20, and I didn't quite make it because I was getting tired of grinding against weak-ass Pokemon. But I tried to catch him up a little bit, and in the progress, because of experience shared, these guys leveled up a little bit as well. But Franklin also learned a brand new move. Not really that useful, but Autotomize, which is basically it ups its speed stat by a lot, which I thought was going to be useful. I replaced something metal sound, I think, which, I mean, I don't really know. I was going to look up stats and see if my Hone Edge would actually learn, like, special defense or special attacks or something later on, but I don't care that much, to be honest. So this is the berry farm. Hey, mister, this way, this way. You! I know this is an unexpected request, but I need you to take care of my berry field. Berries are great. One berry can produce more berries. I assure you that you'll love field work. No. Oh, come on, please take care of the field for me? Yeah, fine. Oh, great. Your name is Josh. Thank you, Josh. I didn't say anything. Oh god, he can read minds. I'm terrified. Oh god. Okay, he's gonna teach us how to plant berries. But it's pretty straightforward. Pretty much put a berry in the ground. I already have some orange berries, but thank you. Oh, he's giving me all kinds of berries, actually. Speaking of berries, actually, on the route that we were fighting a bunch of trainers and stuff in last time, I found a berry tree in there, and also another trainer that I hadn't fought. So I fought him off screen and trained a little bit with them, so just thought I'd mention that. Can't garden like you used to. Well, have your toddler daughter do it, then. So this isn't an entirely important thing, but you can plant berries here. I believe this is the only location in the game that you can plant berries. But I've got a guave berry. And I'm going to plant that because I only have one. I'll plant a berry here. I'll plant an orange berry. Though I might actually give my orange berry to one of my Pokemon that doesn't have a hold item, because I feel like it's just a little extra HP at the end. It's only 10 HP at the very end, and honestly, berries aren't that useful in just, like, their regular state. Okay, well, let's just go through here and water a little bit. The berry farming is kind of okay. Like, I preferred it in past generation games, like second gen, or not second gen, third gen, Ruby, Sapphire, Emerald, where the soil was just scattered throughout the world. I much preferred that style of it, but I don't know if we'll really use this a whole ton. But it's a good place. It's the only place, like, it's good that they have a specific place for it, because their solution in Generation 4 for berries was kind of lame, where they gave you that little pot to plant berries in. I believe that was in Heart Gold and Soul Silver. Okay, how to water, pulling weeds, controlling bug Pokemon, what? Sometimes hungry bug Pokemon are drawn to berry trees. If you don't want them to give, if you don't want to give them all the berries, check the trees and battle against them. Oh, okay, that's actually kind of cool. That kind of combines the whole idea of, like, headbutt in Generation 2, where you headbutted trees that were along the edges of the screen, and you could find bug Pokemon and other kinds of Pokemon in the trees that just fell out when you headbutted them. I mean, it's kind of cool. It's a combination. It's a cool combination of different things that just makes more sense than the way that they used to do things. So this is the daycare here. Oh, am I going to get explained how to use the daycare now? Trevor said he wants to check out the Pokemon daycare. Of course! Of course! Pokemon kind of overdoes it with tutorials. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. That's right. Sometimes we'll find a new addition, like an egg. If you carry an egg around, a Pokemon will emerge from it. Okay, that's thank you. Thank you so much. We know about eggs. Maybe I will! For my dance team? Okay, I'm pretty sure Pokemon are not meant to be dance partners, but that's alright. cool. Okay, well, don't really have a lot of Pokemon that I could put in the daycare right now, but perhaps later I'll use it. It's good for people who want to do, like, EV or IV transfers. If you understand any of that, then you are a way better person than me, because I only understand, like, EVs and IVs at a base level. What are you up to, anyway? Have you seen Dunsparce? Why do you want one of the crappiest Pokemon out there? I don't understand you people. God, you're freaking out now, too. All right, I want to fight you, Painter. What's up, girl? Artist Georgia. Of course she has a Smeargle because she's a painter. Smeargle's a very interesting Pokemon because it has Sketch. It's the only Pokemon that has Sketch, and basically it learns the moves of other Pokemon and then keeps them forever. And I think that's actually a really, really cool tactic. And it can be used in a lot of really, really cool ways, because basically, if you're fighting a Smeargle, you have no idea what it's going to have. Like, it just used, what did it use? Like, Ember or something? It wasn't Ember, because it burned me. I don't think Ember has a chance to burn. But geez, like, wait, what did it just use? I skipped over the text, like, way too fast. Man, okay, I don't want to let Franklin die here. It's super effective because it's a freaking steel type. Yeah, we'll just switch out to... I'll switch out to Jahidi. Give Jahidi some time in the sunlight. I used mostly Doge and Franklin when I was training earlier. Again, I didn't see what that move was. I think it is Ember. I don't know. Maybe I'm crazy now. Smeargle, man. Smeargle. My girlfriend Brooke has this team where she uses a strategy where basically she transfers... She has a Smeargle that has a certain move or a certain set of moves that you can basically get the stats or something, like raise your stats up and then use Baton Pass. It's a Smeargle that has Baton Pass. And basically pass all the stats off onto a Magikarp so she can basically kill people with her... with her level 1 Magikarp or whatever. Oh. You want to battle? Oh, no, she... Oh, he, rather. Just knowing about the same Pokemon as someone else sure make you happy. Okay, well, that's fun. I was hoping to actually battle you because... Oh, hey! Okay, I believe this is going to be our first double battle. I don't think we've done a double battle yet in this game. Have we? No, we must have. We must have, because I think there was some twins that we fought. But we're fighting two Smeargle now. And we're going to... I probably should switch out Franklin. He's still burned. I'll switch him out. That's fine. I like double battles with the AXP share because it basically, like, quadruples all of your experience. You get so much experience from one fight because of the double battle. That was always my favorite part. Doing double battles with, like, the experience share in the past games got you so much if you switched out the Pokemon that you're training. So, I am a fan. I am a big fan. Not a fan of Smeargle using random moves that I've never seen. The other move that I... Actually, it would be really funny if Smeargle got this, too. But have a Smeargle that got... like, a move like Transform, which then copies the moves of the Pokemon that you're transforming to, I believe. Or... Metronome, because it uses a random move from the entirety of the game. You can use any move. I wonder if Metronome can turn out to be Metronome. I don't know if that's a thing that they let happen, but that would be funny. Like, use Metronome, and then it uses Metronome, and then uses another move. Or Metronome again. You just got an endless loop of using Metronome over and over again. I don't think they would let you do that. I think there's some sort of paradox, though, with Metronome, where you use a certain move and, like, it gets you stuck so you can't attack anymore? Is that true? I can't remember, but I'm pretty sure that there's a way that would actually be able to happen. Anyway, we just beat up some painters. All they're doing is being innocent beside the road, just painting some stuff. Man, and here I am beating them all up. All right, so this is actually a new place, and I didn't really use this lot. This is the Battle Chateau. And in my first playthrough, I didn't ever use it until after I beat the Elite Four and came back and checked it out. And I was just like, wait a minute, there's this thing here. and I don't know what it is. But basically, you go in and you can rank up in this battle chateau. It's kind of like, it's almost like a battle tower-esque type thing. It's even got very similar music. Hey, look who it is! It's Viola! That's kind of a surprise. No one could doubt that a kid as strong as you should have one. See, your title here at the Battle Chateau shows everyone just how strong you are. Only a handful of trainers can join the ranks of nobility and earn these titles. Lady Viola, are you acquainted with the young gentleman? Ah, I see you carry the bug badge, young sir. It appears that Lady Viola has recognized your ability as a trainer, then. It's a pleasure to meet you, my lord. My name is Hennessy. May I ask your name? Ah, Sir Josh, a fine name. I will gladly recommend Josh. So will you grant him a beginning title? He has the makings of a very strong trainer, so I'm sure he'll contribute to the Battle Chateau. Of course, ma'am. If you are willing to speak for him, Lady Viola, then that is more than sufficient. And besides, I too sense an extraordinary potential emanating from you, young Sir Josh. Sir Josh, you are hereby granted the title of Baron. Baron Josh. I like that. I like the sound of that. It's got a good ring to it. Trainers with noble titles can do battle against other trainers with titles of nobility here at the Battle Chateau. The title of Baron or Baroness places you at the lowest rank of nobility. Oh, thanks, guy. I thought you were giving me a nice high ranking because I'm a worthy trainer. Continue to battle here and your victories will increase your rank and your title. So basically, you're fighting to become... You're getting more renown, more esteem. It's actually a pretty cool concept. I like the idea of it. Because unlike Battle Tower, where you just get points and then you use those points to buy things, it's like you gain this sense of accomplishment, like real accomplishment. So I could give it a try. Let's do one battle here. Welcome to the show. Let's see. What do you have to say? How many people can assist you, Baron Josh? About Ritz? Of course, it would be my pleasure to explain. From this reception, you will find yourself able to issue a writ of invitation to other players who frequent or humble Battle Chateau. You will discover that there are some differences in the types of trainers you will respond to in your writ, depending on its It is my duty to inform you, however, that you will that we do ask for slight compensation for this service. Okay, that's fine. I just want to battle. No, I'm not going to give you a tip. You didn't do anything. Girl. Friend, lend me your ear, for I am the great Dennis, envy of all, holder of the lofty rank of Baron. You mean the lowest rank here? That's not really a lofty rank there, guy. One word alone appears not in my mighty lexicon. That word is defeat. Somehow I doubt that, good sir. You are challenged by Baron Dennis. Riolu, ah! Now this is an interesting Pokemon indeed, because this is actually a good Pokemon. And I'm gonna kill it. Not with Franklin, though. I'm gonna kill it with Doge. I feel like I should use Jahini, just because. But I'm gonna use Doge. Pika Pika! Ha! Endure failed. Of course it did. Because I didn't attack it. Aha. Unfortunately, I am way OP right now, so I'm just going to take you out in one hit. But that's fine. And I believe with each battle that you win, you gain a new rank. I don't know if it's with every battle that you win, or if it's if you beat all of the battles that are available at that point. Okay, so Nuzzle is going to basically paralyze your target, but also do 20 damage. It's basically like Sand Attack. But instead of lowering accuracy, it paralyzes. It's pretty much the same thing. I'm not interested in learning it because I already have Thunder Wave. And Thunder Wave, I don't really care. I mean, actually, wait a minute. What's the accuracy? It's 100 accuracy. Okay, so really, it's just like the same thing. It's really just the same thing, but it also does damage. So I'll just get rid of Thunder Wave then. It's not terribly good, but, I mean, and perhaps I'll replace it later with something that also does paralysis. But, thank you, Baron Dennis, for this lovely chance to fight you. Oh my god, and I got a lot of money for it, too. Truth is, I'm really not that strong a trainer. You don't say! And I'm pretty sure if we go through and fight all of these trainers, that we'll get a new title, but I'm going to go ahead and cut ahead until I've done that. Franklin grew to level 20 and is learning Shadow Sneak. Let's see. Shadow Sneak does 40 power, and it always goes first. Do we have anything? Yes. Technically, Tackle is a better move, but because it's basically like a ghost version of Quick Attack. So I'm gonna learn that instead. Jahidi also grew to level 25. All right, and that's one down. I don't hold it against you. Losing is part of the game. It's all about having fun. Well, that is for sure. So there's this guy. I should do it this all myself so that no one can say I used my parents' influence. Spoiled rich kid over here. Look at him. Look at him. All right, that's two trainers down. I cannot blame others for my failures. I said I would do this myself. I do believe... Actually, that seems to be all of them. Oh, wait, no, there's some trainers out here that just seem to appear. Ah, this is also a new Pokemon. I don't think we've seen one of these before. This is a Clauncher. I'm not sure if we've seen one, but I'm going to destroy it with Doge. Wow, so electric. Much death. I won't stand for it. You have any idea how much money I've poured into these Pokemon? Spoiled rich people. Look at all this crap. All right. And I do believe this is going to be the last one we fight. Oh, what a thrill from you and your Pokemon. Well, thank you. When do I get a new title? Are these also rooms that I can go into to see if... Oh, there are people here. Ladies and gentlemen, please turn your attention to the entrance and welcome the new Baron Orvault. We hope that you will all welcome him into our midst and train him in our ways. Defeating a simple servant should pose you no problem. Might as well go home. Of course, it's only to be expected that you would defeat a mere servant like me. If you show yourself capable of doing the same to more suitable opponents, your rank will grow faster. So, I mean, as you saw when I walked in there, they basically gave me a new title already. And every time you re-enter this place, there's brand new people to fight all over the place, and they just keep respawning. So it's kind of like a free-roaming Battle Tower-esque scenario. But we're going to head out of here. Oh, farewell, my good sir, before you leave. I have pleasing news to share. Due to your recent excellent battling, you've been granted the title of Viscount. Yeah, see? So every time you leave this place, after you've done a bunch of battles, you gain a new rank. And I believe every time you gain a new rank, you get to fight higher ranked opponents. And I'm sure it keeps going and going. I'm not entirely sure. I've never really played around with it that much. But I'm glad I got to give that a little try and fight a few people and rank up a little bit and level up a little bit as well. But because of my recent level ups, and the fact that I'm really overpowered now, I'm going to go ahead and go into my items here. Excuse me, my key items here. And I'm going to turn off the experience share. My reasoning for this is that I don't want to go through the game and be completely overleveled. The only time I'm going to really use the experience share is if I feel like I'm beginning to get underleveled or off-screen when I'm training and trying to balance out my levels. Because I'm one of those people that plays Pokemon and also balances out all of their Pokemon's levels. I'm a nerd. Because the Pokemon I saw when I was little that I don't remember well. I wonder if filling up my Pokedex will help me remember what it was. That's nice and all. Okay, I'm going to quickly run back to town, heal my Pokemon, and then we'll continue on through the route. So, in the episode where I left Charmander in the PC, I mentioned that I was going to get a Houndour. Unfortunately, after that episode, I looked it up, and apparently Houndour is in Pokemon X, not Pokemon Y. So, what I'm going to do is go into my Pokemon my ex playthrough and trade over a Houndour, because I'll tell you why. The stone, the mega stone for evolving or mega evolving Houndour or Houndoom is in this game. That makes no sense. That makes no sense. It's not available in the other game. It's only available in this game. So they really encourage trading at that point, because Houndoom and Mega Houndoom are amazing. So I'm definitely gonna try that. I've got it. You've got what? A paintbrush? I see. Anyway, as I was saying, it's annoying. Oh, hello. That's pretty cool music, actually. Kind of reminds me of Pokemon Colosseum in XD. Like, the music that plays in that. It's really neat. If you don't mind, if you all don't mind, I'd like to have a Pokemon battle with everyone. Now, who should we pair up? Let's go with Tierno and Trevor against Jepsen and me. Oh, okay, that sounds really cool, actually. Since we're neighbors, we might as well battle together, right? I like double battles like this, where an NPC is also helping you out. It's a double battle where an NPC like gets to pick three of their Pokemon, and you get to pick three of your Pokemon to send into battle, and they automatically choose everything. I think that's really cool. Look at that. Cool. All right, I'm gonna Shadow Sneak your Pikachu. The first time that this was seen was in Pokemon Emerald, where you battle alongside Steven in the Space Center, which I think is really cool. That's a really cool addition. I hope we get to see that fight, actually, and that whole scenario in the Space Center in Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, because that was an Emerald-only event. And I feel like we're gonna see some of that. Although, apparently, Nintendo copyrighted the or trademarked the title Delta Emerald. So that could be a thing. I don't think it will. I think it's just like an in case they decide to do such a thing in the future. Because they've never done that with the remix, right? They've never come out with a third version of the remix. Although, it looks like they're leading up to the fact that Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire are supposed to be more than a remake. They're going to have more deeper story elements that involve like ancient Pokemon and the whole primal reversion thing. It's kind of like reverse mega evolution, like reverting ancient Pokemon to their original forms. I think these are the coolest thing ever. Sorry if you're trying to avoid Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire spoilers, and I just totally spoiled something for you. But I mean, at this point, you ought to expect that you're gonna get spoiled on stuff like that. I think it's a little silly spoiling stuff like that. I mean, in the past, I've always tried to avoid like looking at things that involve quote unquote spoilers of the game. But I've realized as I've done more with videos and done more YouTube stuff, it's important for me specifically to know these things. God damn it, why am I paralyzed? How dare you? It's important for me specifically to know these things as a content creator so that I can then tell you guys, for anybody who's interested, you know, like making videos where I can talk about my thoughts on these future things. It's important. It's content that people want to watch. Flabebe, you're gonna die. You're gonna be dead with Shadow Sneak so bad. Feels so good. We just dominated them. Actually, I'm pretty sure that Serena lost a Pokemon. I didn't. I'm OP. I don't know about Serena, though. She's definitely not OP. I like how we just take money from our friends like it's nothing. It sure is interesting to see different trainers' style is. Well, I guess we should head off to Ambrett Town, then. Well, I agree. I agree while you all just stand around doing nothing. Hey, look, it's another photo opportunity. Let's do this. Call Phil the photo guy. What's up, Phil? I want to take a photo, Phil. Let's do it. Oh, cool. Okay. I don't know why this is so far, like, actually far away from the thing. Would you like to save this photo? No, that's a terrible photo. Yeah, I'm okay if that disappears. It's a terrible photo. I want to zoom in on me. I wanted to get the sign over there in the shot. Yeah, just like that. Blurry! Yeah, I'll save it. I wish you could take a photo with your Pokemon, like have your Pokemon come out of your Pokeballs. No, sorry, Phil, not this time. Have your Pokemon come out of your Pokeballs and just take pictures with them. Like choose which Pokemon you could take a picture of. I think that'd be cool. Okay, so this is a tree that I can cut down. I have the move cut, but I haven't taught it to a Pokemon. Maybe I will sometime soon. We have a couple caves here. Let me see. What is this cave? Connecting cave. Unfortunately, I believe connecting cave is closed for the most part. I think there's a way to get through it. Yeah, I think there's a way to get through it. But unfortunately, the actual shortcut is blocked off when we get in there. The Smeargle killed itself. His one and only sketch move missed or ran out, and he just used struggle. Oh man, there's so many Pokemon in this grass. Oh hey, it's a Krogunk. That's a good Pokemon. There's actually a lot of good Pokemon here. I might have to consider catching some of these. I'd love to use a Krogunk. All right, I just want to get this berry. I just want to get this berry. God damn it! Is that a good Pokemon? I don't think that's a good Pokemon. It's a cute thing that I can kill. Also, I don't know if you noticed this, but in this battle here, I'm going to show a little screenshot of it right now. You can see the berry tree in the background of the battle. How freaking cool is that? That they include stuff like that in the battle scene. Okay, now I'm going to have a heck of a time getting back. Because I found freaking three Pokemon in that tiny little short period of time. I hear if you walk, it finds Pokemon less, if that makes sense. Words are hard. Hi, Krogunk. Okay, all right. So in the next episode, we'll continue on into Connecting Cave and make our way to Ambrett Town. But for now, I want to say goodbye to you folks. Thank you all for watching. If you liked this video, please hit like. If you really like this video, please consider subscribing if you haven't done so already. My name is Josh Jepson. Don't forget that. And I will see you in the next one.